is John Finnemore's Souvenir Programme.
So, Laura, what's your new guy like then?
Oh, are you seeing someone?
Yeah, just started, yeah.
Well, so, what's he like?
Well, you know, it's still very early days, but I like him. I really like him.
Well, that's great. Well, who is he? We're allowed to know?
Yeah, I think you both know him, actually. Ed Reachman?
Oh, yeah, we know him a bit. He's really nice, isn't he?
Yeah, Ed's a great guy.
Yeah, he's really funny.
He is funny.
Yeah, really, really funny guy. And not violent at all.
What?
I said he's not violent. Not at all.
He's not violent?
No. And as you say, he's funny.
Yeah, but did he used to be violent?
No, that's the great thing about him. He's never been violent.
But his friends are?
Are they? I didn't know that. Well, all the more credit to him for not being then.
Tom?
No, really, I don't know what Nick means at all. Ed's not violent.
No, that's what I said.
But if he's not, why would you say he wasn't?
Well, you've answered your own question there, haven't you?
Nick, if you told me you were going out with someone and I said, oh, great, she never sets fire to things, what would you think?
I'd be pleased.
You wouldn't be a bit worried, a bit unsettled?
No. Well, I suppose I might wonder why you hadn't said whether or not she was violent.
Right, fine. Well, I think I'm going to go.
No, Laura, don't.
No, I think I will. Bit of a walk. See you. Bye.
Nick, wouldn't it just be easier to tell her that you fancy her?
No. It's not my style. I'm just going to subtly put her off every other man in the world.
Welcome to the Pittman Museum of Fine Arts. For the standard audio tour of the collection, press 100. For a guide aimed at older children, press 200. And for a guide aimed at five-year-olds, press 300. You've selected the audio tour for five-year-olds. To begin, enter the large vaulted gallery across the hall. Devoted chiefly to artifacts from the civilizations of ancient South Asia, it contains arguably one of the most fascinating exhibits in the whole museum. You can find it between the big pot and the carpet with all the cross men fighting. And it's a quite remarkable example of an early 21st century fire extinguisher. Made in 2008 by C.H. Sharp and Company, fire extinguishers like this one are used every day by real firemen in yellow hats. It's a very different world from ours, but perhaps we can get just a sense of what it must be like for them by running round and round the room pretending to be a fire engine. Ninor, Ninor. When you finish doing that, step through the arch to your right into the gallery at the early Flemish masters, where, if you stand on tippy toes and look out the window, you can see a lorry.
Can I have a word with you, son?
Anytime you like, Moon.
Well, look, don't take this the wrong way, but I was wondering if you would mind, possibly, just backing off a bit.
From you?
From me and from the Earth.
Okay. Might be tricky. Why, though?
Well, it's just the Earth and I are getting on really well at the moment.
Oh, yes?
Yeah, we've got this shared interest in tides. And the thing is, when you come round every day, it's making me look a bit bad in comparison.
Oh, right.
Yeah. There I am, shining my hardest, illuminating everything, and you know what they call it? Night.
Oh, dear. So let's see if I've got this straight. You want me to back away from the Earth, leaving the Earth where it is.
Please.
And you want me to stop coming round the Earth so often?
Would you mind? I just think it would make me look better.
Leaving aside certain practical difficulties, better in what way?
Well, you know, brighter.
Oh, I see. You want me to go further away so that your light, the light you shine, will seem brighter.
Yes. Is that so hard?
It's quite hard.
Look, it's just when I'm compared every day with a vast miasma of incandescent plasma like you, I can't help feeling a bit
eclipsed.
I knew you weren't fine with that. How many times do I have to say I'm sorry?
No, I am fine with it. It was funny. Hey, Earth, look, look, I'm as big as the sun. Oh, it was a funny joke.
Yeah.
Because it's so untrue. So untrue.
Yes, I know.
But anyway, look, I'd like to help. I'd be quite happy to move away, leave you and the Earth where you are, and let you beam forth your powerful moonlight in peace.
Oh, thanks.
I just don't think it's possible.
Not possible.
No, sorry.
Right, fine, no worries. Stuck up sod. Thinks the world revolves around him. Have you heard the good news about Jesus?
No, what is it?
Matt West have approved his mortgage application. So he's going to buy that flat in Cirencester.
Oh, that's great. Where's he staying till then?
He's going back to see his family in Portugal. And he's invited us to go and stay with him.
That's amazing. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Amen.
Hear my plight, O mighty King Solomon, whose wisdom is praised above all things.
Oh, not all things. Just a lot of things.
Great king, this woman stole away my child in the night and now saith that it is hers.
Is that what you saith?
Aye, and I say it truly. This woman here, O wise and sagacious king, pretends my own child is hers that she might take it from me.
Right, so you both say the kid's yours?
Yes.
All right, then which of you can tell me this? What is his name?
Aaron.
Eli.
Aha! Of course, for this to work, I need to know what his name really is. What is it?
Eli.
Aaron.
Ah, I thought that might work. Okay. Oh, ah, try this. What colour are his eyes?
Brown.
Brown.
Really? You're both saying brown?
They are brown.
You sure? Because if when I take my hand away, it turns out they're not brown, you both lose. So simple game theory would suggest that one of you should switch to blue. No? Neither of you? Okay, let's have a look. Yep, they're brown. Oh, I know. Let's put him in between you. You both call him and see who he comes to.
He can't walk.
No, but he can sort of wriggle about, can't he?
No.
Oh. To be honest, then, that beats me why you're both so keen on him. Oh, I've got it now. This is a really good one. Bring me a sword.
A sword? What do you want a sword
for? I'll tell you what I want a sword for, thank you. With this sword, I shall divide the living child in twain and give half unto one and half unto the other.
That's just stupid.
It's not stupid. It's the wisdom of Solomon, so shut up.
It is stupid. You'd just kill him.
Yeah, I know I'd kill him. I know what swords are for, thank you very much. It's the only way to be fair.
It's not fair. It's crazy.
Don't worry. He's not going to do it. It's a trick.
I am going to do it. I'm going to cut him in half. Right now. With this sword. Unless one of you stops me. Because I am a wise and just king, I will now bisect this little baby. Oh, come on, one of you back down.
No.
I wasn't going to do it, but you know what? Now I'm going to have to. Do you want it done lengthways or down the middle?
No, no, let it happen.
Well, don't both say it. What's the point of you both saying it?
What did you think? One of us would go, oh, well, half a dead baby's better than no baby.
Yes, I thought only the mother would give up her claim to save the baby.
No, we both like the baby. That's the whole problem.
You're an idiot.
Well, look, I'm sorry. I'm trying my hardest here. I'm sorry if my wisdom's not wise enough for you. I'm just trying to do the right thing for little Isaac.
His name's Eli.
No, it's,
Aha!
Aaron!
Too
Aaron.
Late!
Damn it!
The wisdom of Solomon, ladies. Never underestimate it.
This gallery is devoted to the masterpieces of the Italian Renaissance, but they're all boring. There is one of a horsey, but whilst it is a capable rendering, it is badly let down by the artist's failure to show the horsey doing a poo. However, you may notice something about this gallery that's rather special. It's really, really long and thin, and although there's carpet down the middle, fascinating, this has been removed at either side, revealing the highly polished wood that lies beneath. It is thought by many that if we were to take off our shoes and run as fast as possible, we could do epic skitsies. Skitsies!
Ooh. This summer, an epic motion picture brings you the romance, the danger, the compulsion of the only remaining form of transport we haven't done a film about yet. Stoppable, the tram story. Starring Ollie Rockbrooker as Sam the Tram Armstrong.
Sam, please, I'm begging you, stay away from the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.